Hey guys, thanks for watching another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here at Webtegrity in San Antonio, Texas, and we have over 200 videos now inside of this YouTube channel helping you with all things WordPress. Today we're going to look at child themes. We've talked about them in the past, but today we have a question coming off of Twitter from Angie asking, what is a child theme? And do I even need one? So we're gonna look at that question today. What is a child theme? The easiest way to explain it is that it's another theme that you activate inside of your WordPress dashboard, and it basically inherits the parent theme. So there would be two themes in a sense playing together. One is the parent theme and the other one is the child theme. The parent theme really holds all the functionality. It has all the bells and whistles. So this would be like your major theme that you want to use. A child theme would come into play. You would create and activate a child theme if you wanted to make certain customizations. Doing this allows you to make easier updates. So as the parent theme has an alert to you that says, hey, you're going to need to update this theme, you certainly don't want to lose any of your extra customizations. Now, don't panic, because a lot of times customizations are saved inside of the parent theme itself, such as when you upload your logo or change the colors of your theme. These things very typically all will always stay saved as you click update inside of a theme. So why do you need a child theme? When would you actually need one? Here's the deal. You don't really need a child theme unless you're gonna go crazy style into the PHP files or into the style sheet and go make some fun changes. So let me show you kind of what that looks like. So going into the CSS file, you know, when you click on appearance and go to editor and you see all this fun stuff, if you really wanna make a change to something to manipulate a color or a spacing issue or whatever you wanna change inside of your CSS, then you need a child theme. Or some themes are very generous and give you something called a custom CSS box. You can make your change inside there and overwrite the parent theme without ever even having to have a child theme. Wow, is your mind blown yet? Slow down. Hold on. Listen to me for a second. Changing something inside your style sheet. Super simple to do if you understand CSS, right? You can go into this file and overwrite a change. The problem is, as soon as the theme itself requires an update, this style sheet will be reset back to the default. You will lose your customization. So in order to save that, WordPress has come up with the idea of these child themes. That's really what it is. And also diving into any sort of a PHP file, you know, if you're over here inside of any of your PHP files and you want to make a change to something in here, this again will be overridden whenever you update the theme. So you certainly want to have a child theme in place if you're going crazy style and tinkering with all this nerd code. If you only need to make a few changes to the CSS, you can even just install a plugin called Simple Custom CSS. And that will give you, if we go into here, go in Appearance and go into Custom CSS, that will give you a little CSS box that you can overwrite anything inside of the parent theme. Again, without needing a child theme, without going to all the extra effort to make a child theme. Some theme authors are super generous, and whenever you get their theme and install it, inside of the zipped file, you might find one or two other style sheets and files that would be, in fact, your child theme. So check this out, Avada does that. Whenever you install Avada, it has multiple child themes and you can pick and choose from different child themes so that you get totally different looks. That's what all these are down here. It's pretty crazy cool what you can do with child themes, but the truth is most of us don't need them ever because you're not going into the CSS, you're not going into the PHP files. But if you are, I have two other videos that we've created. I'll show you what those are. This is Jason, he's our lead developer, and he did a video on how to build a child theme from scratch. So you can check this video out. I'll put the link to that in the description box below. That's if you really want to be crazy nerdy. If you just want to figure out how to do it using a plugin, of course there's a plugin for that. So I have another video here of how to make a WordPress child theme from a plugin. And again, I'll put the links to these two videos in the description box below. I hope this helps you a little bit understand and not freak out when it comes to somebody said I need a child theme. You really don't, unless you're going to go into the CSS or go into the PHP. Then you're going to need that so that you can safely update. All right, I hope that helps. If you guys have any questions, throw them in the comments below. I'll see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.